Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Civilization 3. I went into the Civ 3 application and made a fix because yesterday when I was, every time I won a battle, the screen will blink and it'll do that little, the circle disc thing from Windows will pop up. So I've set it to compatibility mode with Windows XP and it seems to be working a lot better now. So we'll see how it goes. Let's see here. Why is this guy just not doing anything? I should clear that. What tile is this? Grassland. No shield, so we'll irrigate that. So, I was talking to myself earlier before recording. There's the temptation is great to. Oh, someone's revealed the capital. So I forgot that there is the wonder cascade in this game where the shields you spend towards one wonder can go into another. The goal, I guess, when you're in a very tight spot like this one is actually to go to war early. If I remember correctly, my strategy, Civ 3 strategy correctly, is you want to grab your enemy's territory as soon as possible. Okay, goodbye. In their borders, it's just hard to see with all the jungle around it. Now let's build a catapult instead. So catapults are like civilian units, they can be captured, they have no defense. Build a barracks here as well. Let's build a worker. And then back to horses are 2-1-2, spears are 1-2-1. Archers are, I think, 2 for attacking, 1 for defense. Let's build some horses. Okay. Alright, I think I need to move my units into a barrack city to be able to upgrade them. So, that's good that I have barracks here, so I'm going to move my warrior here into a barracks, and I'm going to move this guy into... And I'm going to get to those dyes early before the Zulus do. Looks like they just have military units there patrolling. Nothing much, so I'm gonna wake these two units. Move them in. I assume there might be a barbarian camp down there. Okay, so I've hooked that up. I'm gonna add a road there so this city is connected. I'd have to go to war with him again. It's hard to see. There should be lines. Let's see here. Nope, they don't have a settler. They're just... And they have a peace treaty with us for 20 turns, so I don't think they can surprise attack us. And I don't think they do that much anyways. At least not in the sense of pre-planned surprise attacks. From what I've been told, just watching, reading a lot of forums and the developers answering questions is, in this game, let's build Kura and explore the coast. In this game, the AI will do a random number generator roll and see who they attack next. So most of the time they don't attack anyone. There might be other things that go into it, like are we ready to attack, stuff like that, but the diplomacy in this game is very much grounded by the opinion system, like polite, cautious, and all these numbers roll into like a single number. It's very much like Civ 4. Civ 4 built a lot on top of that. Oh, they have workers. I want to buy their workers. You want to buy people's workers because, one, they are actually free of unit support. They count as slaves, so they're better deal than your normal worker. Oh, actually, we can give them a tech and get some gold back in return. Okay. Except the Xerxes, yes. Yeah, this is why you want to keep checking your, Okay, looks like the Celts are... So, slave workers work at half speed, but if you have enough of them, it doesn't matter. So let's build some more horses. Thank you. Right. I remembered the stack unit movement now. J command. Okay, we're gonna move from here. Hook that up. Losing those two workers early on was a big setback for us. So let's see what we can do with the Persians. I think I'm gonna take these three cities here in Sidon and Tyre. Well, might as well. Assuming we can get there, we don't fail. Okay, let's do that. Preview of their units. Oh, they have immortal, so not a good idea to attack the Persians, because that's going to kick off their golden age as well. So we're back to attacking the Zulus. With the Zulus. Gotta fix the road system again. What a pain. See here. Well, we can't ask for rite of passage yet because we don't have the requisite technology. Barbarians coming up here. Pulling him back here. Okay. Okay. I'm gonna come here and fix this. This is the part I don't like. You have to really do optimal play, you have to do a lot of things that I'm not doing, like counting the number of shields because there's no overflow, and that just absolutely drives me insane. I mean, some people love it, but not me. And one of the other things is you have to check your diplomacy screen each turn to see if there's any deals you can buy, you can engage in. It's not clear what is available. Get it for cheaper. Now we'll come back to them later. Mass upgrade, I forgot how to do it. enough units, you know, I think. One thing about Civ 3 though is you can stack all your workers and do things super fast. Tech trading here is a big exploit in some cases, but I kind of like the feeling of being in charge. Establish the embassies, don't we? Yeah, we haven't built any embassies. You're building settlers, have some Zulu warriors. Espionage system in Civ 3 is mostly menu driven. It's similar to in Civ 5. Rome. the Zulus. How much money do they want? Let's try 50 gold. 100 gold? How about 80? Split, or 75, split the difference. Give them that, and then we get trade for polytheism. Can we get their gold back as well? That way we get the money back that we paid for. Let's try 100. 173. All of their gold. Okay. They're way back. Oh, we can now do Redis patches, but they're way back technologically and they have nothing to give us. Same with the Romans, Persians. Yeah, they're tech. There is my stack of doom. Three catapults, bunch of swords, bunch of spears, bunch of horses. Let's change that to a catapult. Wake all units. We're gonna start our attack soon. One thing with Civ is you don't want to over prepare. In Civ 3, I remember I used to sit on my stack of doom for so long trying to get the perfect combination, and by the time I did that, the AI has already moved on to a new unit. So let's see here, what can I do? Let's build another worker. I'm gonna buy a rite of passage with Rome. Sell them some. Oh, they got some techs. Polytheism. 39. Yeah, I don't think they'll ever. Because I attacked the Zulus by mistake when they built their city right on top of where my units were, and I declared war right away. That counted against me. It counted as an exploit. But actually, it wasn't an exploit, it was just. I forgot about it. But, yeah. So that was a stupid thing on my part. Okay, so let's see here. Temporary stack of units. So in this game, the cities don't have health bars, you just have to kill all the units defending in the city. So in a way, the health bars of a city is dependent on the number of units defending it. But because you can bring as big or as small a stack that you can or want, the health bar becomes academic because you can bring your own big stack to attack. And you can see here in between turns, the AI fortifying their city because they see that I have units on their borders. Try to get my Kura out to sea first before I attack. Okay, so that's connected. Let's try to do something. also build units here. Let's move our stack of workers here. Yeah, they won't do it. I think the mausoleum was just built. Cusco. So we'll switch to Temple of Artemis. move our swords here. Let's build more. Yeah, spear is fine for now. I forgot the range of these units here. I pulled back my workers. Alright, so I think we're set for war, but I'll do that next time. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you next time.